Hello once again. There are many videos on YouTube about the atrocity that Muhammad, the founder of Islam, have committed throughout his life. I would like to give my own perspective as an ex-Muslim about his doing and what the Muslim, or yeah, Muslim, some people call it Islamic, but actually the Muslim, the true Muslims groups who are committing the same atrocity today, such as ISIS, Al-Nusra, Boko Haram. The list is long. Anyway, today I'd like to speak to you about the rape of Safiya bint Huyay, Muhammad, the founder of Islam, raped a young girl, young lady, was newly married, wedded. He raped her, and the Muslim clerks try to justify that by saying she loved Islam and she became a Muslim. So I'm going to look carefully into that. Safiya bint Huyay, her father was Al-Akhtab ibn Huyay, or Huyay ibn Al-Akhtab. Muhammad, I'm sorry, the name is not so important as the deed of this so-called prophet is more important. It is of a more importance than the names. This young lady was newly married, living with her tribe in a town called Khaybar. And Muhammad goes to invade this town. He kills between 600, not kill, I'm sorry, slaughter. Killing is like if two armies are fighting one another and you get soldiers killed on this side and soldiers got killed on that side. That's how people, when there's a war, two armies are clashing with one another, and it's a, in a way, a fight. But these people were peaceful, they were not fighting. They were in their homes. They didn't want to fight with Muhammad or against him. They just want to be left alone. And because they didn't take his side, they didn't fight with him on his side and kill others and loot their wealth, they became his enemies. So he decided to go and attack them. They surrendered. But that was not enough for the bloodthirsty Muhammad. That was not enough to surrender. So he ordered all the men of 13 and up to be slaughtered. The younger ones were sold as slaves. They were divided among his army to be used as slaves. They can do whatever they want with them. They can abuse them physically, sexually, sell them to other people, enslave them to do labor work, whatever they want. They are slaves. And the women, they were given as booties, as gifts to his army. So here the daughter of the head of the tribe saw her father slaughtered, killed, her brother killed. Her husband was killed, but before killing her husband, he was in charge of the treasury, so he knew where the money is kept safe. He wouldn't tell them where the money is. So they light fire on his chest first. They tortured him. We're wondering why ISIS is so brutal. Well, don't look too far. Muhammad did that. Did worse stuff than ISIS. He light fire on his chest to tell him where the money is. When they got the money, it was not that. They told him that's not enough. There must be more. When he didn't talk, they stuck his neck. They slaughtered him. That was her husband. They killed her brother. They killed her uncles from her father's side, her uncles from the mother's side, and her mother was given as a slave to be raped by Muhammad's army. All the women, all the girls were given to please, to sexually please Muhammad's army. We see that today as sickening and disgusting. And back then it was sickening and disgusting. The Jewish people of Khaybar did not want to have themselves involved in these activities. They were religious Jews, and to them this is not good. This is against their tradition. To rape people, to steal their money in their teaching. Don't steal, don't kill. Don't covet your neighbor's wife. So they couldn't unite with Muhammad in his teaching to go out and loot caravan and invade other towns and loot their money. And for that they paid with their lives. Safiya, the young girl, the bride, was actually given to another man to be his slave. But some people told Muhammad that this is a beautiful girl and she's the daughter of the head of the tribe. So he looked at her and he found out that she's young and she's beautiful. So he exchanged her. He gave the other guy 7 slaves in exchange for Safiya bint Huyay because she's young and beautiful. And he decided on his way back after the murder to have sexual relationship with her, and she refused. She refused. The thing is, he ordered some of the women who are coming to help the fighters to prepare food and stuff to them to wash her and clean her because she put dirt on her head and her face when she saw what happened to her family and to her tribe. She screamed and dumped dirt on her head. So he ordered the women to wash her and clean her. Even after she refused to have a relationship with him. Suddenly, after they wash her and clean her and prepare her for him, all of a sudden, she agrees to Muhammad's sexual advances. And the justification we hear from the Muslim clerks now is because she loved Islam and she really loved the Prophet. But she was afraid that her people might harm him if they find out that she slept with him. And the question here that Muslims really don't ask is, all the tribe is dead. They're all dead. Who is coming after him? Who will come after him? They're gone. Muhammad murdered them all. And those who were alive, they were kids and women, slaves like her. No. Reality is, the time they were washing her and cleaning her and preparing her for him to rape her, they put her in front of reality. Okay, you have nobody now, no father, no mother, no brother, no nobody to go back to. What are you going to do? If you go now, his army will eat you up, will rape you and then kill you. All of them, they will have party on you. So what do you want to do? Only one man rapes you or the whole army? I think it's very obvious. An hour or two later, after they washed her, she came and she submitted to Muhammad. The same happened with another woman, Rihanna. The same thing, out of fear. By the way, Rihanna, soon after she submitted, she died. She died because she became so depressed and so heartbroken. She died. Nobody in his right mind or in her right mind will accept such behavior. Muhammad, I believe he was mentally ill, he was a mentally disturbed person. And that we see in the groups that they are following him. The behavior of ISIS, the behavior of Boko Haram, the behavior of Nusra, all these Al-Qaeda, all these Islamic groups are doing what Muhammad had done in the beginning. Shocking, and people don't want to believe that because it is so painful, especially to Muslims, to face this reality. But we all have to speak up. The change is on the way. We have to push harder for the change to happen. Saudi Arabia, the very heart of Islam, is changing now, and it's changing fast because they know the end is near and the rope is tightening around their neck, and they have to really find a way out from this ideology. Now they started to reject the hadith. That's the first step. Soon they will change things in the Quran. they may keep only the Quran that came in Mecca when Muhammad was weak. He didn't speak of fighting or killing or murder or anything. And soon we get rid of this ideology once and for all. Thank you very much. God bless you. See you again.